Good morning, students. We are going to discuss a new topic today, which will be density. Let us see what it is. Density is defined as mass per unit volume. Mass per unit volume. And we can write this in this form also, density equal to mass upon volume. That means to measure the density of an object, to calculate the density of an object, we have to divide the mass of an object by the volume occupied by the object. When you divide these two, you will be getting the density. Now you should also know here that density has the unit. SI unit is kg per meter cube. Kg per meter cube, which can also be written in this form, kg meter to the power minus 3. We have another unit which is called CGS unit, which is gram per centimeter cube or gram centimeter to the power minus 3. Now one very important thing come here to convert kg per meter cube into gram per centimeter cube and vice versa. So to convert kg per meter cube to gram per centimeter cube, in this case, we have to divide by 1000. So when you divide the number by 1000, we can convert kg per meter cube into gram per centimeter. For example, suppose we have 500 kg per meter cube and we want to convert it to gram per centimeter. So in this case, we have to divide by 1000. So on dividing by 1000, we are getting the answer as 0.5 gram per centimeter. Same way, we can also convert gram per centimeter cube to kg per meter cube. This is gram per centimeter cube to kg per meter cube. How to convert it? And to convert it, we need to multiply by 1000. An example is there. Suppose we want 0.2 gram per centimeter cube to convert to kg per meter cube. So in this case, this 0.2 should be multiplied by 1000. Now you can cancel this. After removing 0, 10 is there, we can cancel 10. You can see the answer is 200 kg per meter cube. So this is how we can convert kg per meter cube to gram per centimeter cube and also gram per centimeter cube to kg per meter cube. Let us now take an example how to find out the density of an irregular object. But first of all, you should know what is meant by an irregular object or irregular body. It is an object which does not have a definite length, breadth and thickness or height. You might have seen a rock. It does not have definite length, breadth and height, so it is an example of irregular shaped object. Now if such object is given, how can we calculate the density? Let us see. to find density of an irregular object. To find density of an irregular object. Now, in order to find the density, we require two other quantities like the mass of an object and also volume of an object. Remember, mass and volume. Mass can easily be calculated with the help of physical balance. But question comes, how to calculate the volume since it does not have a definite length, breadth or height. Then for this purpose we will be taking a measuring cylinder. Say this is a measuring cylinder where we have to fill water. Say the water is filled up to 50 milliliter. This is the height up to which we have taken the water in a measuring cylinder. Now, this is the stone which is an irregular shape. We have to find the density. For this, immerse the stone into this water. Now, for this, first of all, you have to tie the stone with a string and gently drop this stone into this water so that it is fully immersed. So this is how it looks on immersing into water. This is the stone being immersed. Now, as soon as this object or stone is immersed into water, it is found that the level of water does not remain at 50 milliliter. Instead, it rises. So let us suppose this is the height up to which water has risen and has come up to the new height, and let us suppose now the volume is say 80 milliliter. So you can see now the volume of water is 80 milliliter. So the difference of these two volume will give you the volume of the stone. So we can calculate the volume now, which is 80 minus 50, that is 30 centimeter cube or millimeter. Now I told you we have to also calculate the mass of this stone. With the help of physical balance you can calculate it. And let us suppose the mass is 60 gram. Now it becomes very easy for us to calculate the density because we have the formula, the relation between density, mass and volume, and we can calculate. So we have density equal to mass divided by volume. Now put the values. Density, mass is already given 60 gram, and the volume we have measured it as 30 centimeter cube. Now these two can be cancelled and we will get the answer 2 gram per centimeter cube. We have 2 gram per centimeter. So this is the answer we have calculated. You can see 60 upon 30 on cancelling we got 2 gram per centimeter cube. So this is a method to find out the density of an irregular solid object. I hope it is clear to you. You may also try it at home by taking any irregular shaped object and also by dipping into water, see the change in the volume, and then using the formula try to calculate the density. So next class we will discuss about relative density. Thank you.